I invite Sandi Michels, priest in charge at St. Elizabeth's Christ the King, to make a presentation on efforts toward establishing a lynching memorial in Tarrant County.
Hi. I have to tell you, last night I was at Tarrant County College where this presentation was given by a bunch of students who actually are the ones who sort of put things together. And it's very interesting that I've been spending a lot of time. I can tell you the congregation or the audience last night was almost completely people of color. It was not anything like this. And of course, it was also people who were very much younger than they are. I sort of joke with the members of the coalition that I'm their token old white lady. And I sort of am. But anyway, we have a group. It's called the Coalition for Peace and Justice, the Tarrant County Coalition for Peace and Justice. And we are working as particularly with EJI. Have you ever heard of EJI? Brian Stevenson, the Equal Justice Initiative in Birmingham, Alabama. This was grown out of a, it started in 1989, and Brian Stevenson was a person who was very involved in looking at historical patterns of racial terrorism that has led to mass incarceration and excessive punishment that is prevalent today. And so there's you want to go to the next slide that's got the picture of it. Their mission statement says that they're committed to ending mass incarceration and excessive punishment in the United States, to challenging racial and economic injustice, and protecting basic human rights for the vulnerable people in American society. That's their founding mission. And one of the things that they have done in this mission is to look at the history of lynching as racial terrorism in this country. And they have documented over 4,000 cases of lynchings. They've only looked at the years from 1870 to 1950. So some of the major ones that we know about aren't even counted in that. But there's more than 4,000 of them. And they have to be actual documented cases. They have to be able to, before they're counted. And then in, last year, actually 1918, in April of 1918, they opened the Lynching Memorial in Birmingham, Alabama. There is a museum there that looks at the history of the whole thing. And then the memorial itself, the picture on the right there, is part of the memorial. What it consists of is over 800 steel columns, one for each county in which there is a documented lynching in this country. And every county that has a memorial, they've got the name of the county and the name of the person and the date of whatever lynchings there were. And there are some columns that have 30, and there are some columns that have only one. Thankfully, Tarrant County only has one. But what they invite people to do, if you ever go to this memorial, there are duplicate columns of these steel, they're about coffin-sized, and they hang from the ceiling. And they invite the counties to bring that memorial back to their own county, the duplicate, and erect it somewhere where it's prominent in the county. And our coalition was formed to do that, to try to bring the memorial here to Tarrant County. All of the people in this coalition, it's a very informal sort of group. I got involved with it because in June I made a trip to Birmingham to see the memorial and found out about this possibility of bringing it here, and they said to start getting, well, I found out there was a group here that was working, and so I've been working to be a part of that. And there's three steps to the process of getting the monument. There are three steps to getting the monument. The first step is to have a soil collection, where you go to the place where lynchings happened, and you literally gather soil. And they have gallon jars that they put, there's a whole wall of them at the museum in Birmingham, and they have them in different places, but you collect soil from the places where lynchings occurred. The next step is a historical marker that you put up, and then the final step is where they bring the monument itself. And so we are about to go through the first of these steps, and there's going to be a soil collection in December. December 12th is the anniversary of the 98th anniversary of our lynching here in Tarrant County. And so we're meeting on December 12th at the site of the lynching, which is at the corner of 12th and Samuels. I'll tell you a little bit more about it. These are images of lynchings. Most of the time, as you know, there are many, many images. They used to sell postcards of lynchings. We don't have any images of our Tarrant County lynching here. The one there is in Waco, Texas, the lynching of Jesse Washington, which was one of the very worst of them. And then the other one is a Texas one, too. They picked two of the Texas ones there. Go on. But ours, the person who was lynched is a man named Fred Rouse. And, you know, the thing about lynching victims, we generally don't know anything about them. They're sort of anonymous, almost. And what we're trying to do with this process is to make him into a person, to get some sort of an idea of who he is, to remember this person who was Fred Rouse. That is the certificate. The thing we know about him is that he was worked at the stockyards. There was a strike at the Swift Company, and they hired all sorts of scabs, as they normally do, and a lot of people of color were hired to work at the thing. And on December 6th, I think it was, there was a big riot, and they had all sorts of, you know, there were things that were going on. And Fred Rouse decided that he was not willing to just passively be beaten to death. He had a gun, and he actually shot two people. And that, of course, ignited the crowd even more. They stabbed him, they beat him, so that literally they thought that he was dead. He was taken to the morgue, because they were sure that he was dead. It turned out he wasn't. And so they put him in the basement of the city hospital to await charges, whatever charges he was going to have. But on the evening of December 11th, the Klan came in to the hospital and took him away, 35 men in the Klan, and took him to 12th and Samuels and hung him from a tree there and shot him 8 times. And they found his body the next day. We do know something about the perpetrators. Actually, 3 people were charged with this murder. They never got indictments, but they were charged, and of course they were never tried and nothing ever happened. One of them is, several of them were actually involved with law enforcement. There are, you know, all sorts of things that go on with that. But anyway, that is our one lynching in this state, this county. What we're thinking of doing is having a memorial, having the plaque, the second stage, having the plaque maybe at 12th and Samuels, which nobody will ever see because it's a very unpopulated part of town. But the hospital, where the hospital was, is downtown. And maybe having a plaque there where they kidnapped him from the hospital and took him. And then eventually, when we finally get to the memorial, we think that probably the proper place for that is on the courthouse lawn, probably right next to the Civil War Memorial. We need to have some sort of context for all of these things that are going on. There's another part of this thing that our coalition is working on too, because of course the whole point of this is that this is a continuum. This is the legacy of slavery which lives on in this country. And literally, you know, there's several different stages of it. The lynching stage was one stage of it. Eventually, people decided that it was much more efficient to use the death penalty to take care of these things. And we led to mass incarceration, you know, all of the things that we all know something about, but we're beginning to learn even more. And if we're going to have any kind of racial healing and any kind of real reconciliation, we need to face the history of what we have done in this country. And one of my personal goals for all of this is to find ways to convince white people that it's our issue too, that we are involved in this and that we need to be involved in reconciliation and taking care of it, making it better. At the building here, you might recognize, and you might have heard a little bit about it, this is another part of it. This is the pecan factory that's on Main Street. Just as you go north out of town and you go under the bridge there, there's a building over there. It actually was built in the 20s to be a Ku Klux Klan meeting place. And it was used that way for a while, but then it had damage. And for a long time, it was used as a pecan factory. What we want to do, maybe, if this is a huge dream, would be to restore this building and make it a community center, a venue, an entertainment venue, a museum, a memorial, you know, all of those sorts of things that can be a part of that and make it a community center. That's a problem because it's everybody wants that property. You can make a lot of money with that property, and of course we don't have a lot of money. But that's the dream, that maybe we'd be able to do something with that. This next slide shows again that we are not really finished with this yet. We are still dealing with the legacy of slavery and lynching and all of the things that goes with it. And obviously those are, as you know, the final one over there is the man in Staten Island that was killed. I think maybe what we really ought to put as the last one in this is a picture of a Tatiana Jefferson. Because I think, as I say, we are still really dealing with that. So there are two events that we have planned that I want to bring to your attention and see if anybody wants to be a part of that. One of them is on December 2nd at the Shamley Library. I don't know where that is, but I'm going to find out. Where there's going to be a presentation about Fred Rouse and all of the things that part of it. So you've heard part of what's going to happen there. And then on the 12th is the soil collection. And everybody is invited to come and be a part of that. And that, of course, is actually at 12th and Samuels where the thing is. Anyway, I just wanted everybody to know what is going on with that. And if you would like to come and be part of the coalition, we can always use more people. As I say, it is very, very informal, and anybody who comes is very welcome.